not much older than you, I got a hold of some of the first Spider-Man comic books that Steve Ditko drew, and I became very, very excited about them because I really loved the artwork that he did, and I really loved you know, the way he told the story, and because I was a teenager like Peter Parker who had trouble with girls, I could relate to that nerdy aspect of the way Steve Ditko portrayed Peter Parker. So I just found it all, and then you know, Stan Lee's great scripting. I just found it all fun and exciting and a big thrill. So I really got turned on to Ditko, and he was the first artist first comic book that I really noticed that, you know, it was signed by somebody. There was an actual artist behind the comic, you know, so that made me excited because I thought, like, I might want to become a cartoonist and like Steve Ditko, my hero.
Who is your favorite character drawn by Steve Ditko?
Dr. Strange, no doubt. Dr. Strange, I think, is very cool. I love the way he does the hands and the whole mystical thing. And Steve Ditko thought of Dr. Strange on his own. That was his own creation. And, so, you know, I really looked into all those crazy backgrounds, those worlds that Dr. Strange flies around in. I think those are very cool.
Do you have a favorite comic book drawn by him?
Well, I really do like the Conga and Borgo monster comics he did. So here, I'll show you.
Alright, so
this is the Conga book that I sent you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this the thickest book you got in your collection?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I love these stories, just the way he showed the monster and everything. I think, did you read all the stories?
Not yet.
Not yet. Oh, well, there's so many of them. You'll have to spend a lifetime reading them and rereading them. So, Kong is my favorite comic book that he's been through, I guess.
Have you ever met or spoken with him?
Sure. I used to be the creative director of Jim Henson's Muppets. Are you familiar with the Muppets?
Yeah.
And so when I worked for Jim, I invited Steve over for lunch one day to get a tour of where we made the puppets, the creature shop. And so he came over for lunch, then I gave him a tour of the creature shop, which he really enjoyed. He was so interested in the creativity behind the Muppets. And then I took him over to our offices and introduced him and Jim Henson. So the guy who brought Kermit to life and the guy that brought Spider-Man and Doctor Strange to life, I introduced them and they shook hands, and that was like a very, very exciting moment for me. And then Steve invited me over to his studio, you know, to reciprocate nicely, and so I spent an afternoon over at his little studio and saw where he drew all those great comics, and got to talk to him, so that was very nice of him to do.
How did you get the idea to write 4 books about Steve Ditko's comics?
Well, I've done over 100 books, but the first book I did was on Steve Ditko because he was so influential to me when I was a teenager. You know, he's the one that really got me really excited about comics and comics, a career related to comics. And it was just out of passion, you know. I couldn't not do it because he's such a hero to me and an inspiration. So, yeah, I've done 4 Steve Ditko comics. I might do some more. Would you like that?
Yeah.
Good.
Do you read the newer books by Steve Ditko?
Yeah, I like his new stuff. I think he's still being very creative, and I admire the fact that, you know, when he's in his 80s, he's still drawing comics. He has a passion for comics, that's for sure. And the fact that he's doing this great stuff to this day, you know, it's a thrill, and I think it's very good.
are they appropriate for me?
Oh, are those comics appropriate? Well, they're a little deep. Steve at this time in his life is very philosophical, so they're a little deep. I don't think they're inappropriate, but they're a little bit even hard for me to understand. So they can read them. I think they're appropriate to read and to reread to try to really understand, his point of view. And they're worth digging into. You might enjoy Spider-Man or Doctor Strange a little bit more, but there's some good things to think about in what he's currently doing.
Thank you for answering my question.
Oh, dude, it was a great thrill. I really enjoyed talking.